Righto, Talio there, champs. Now, we're going to be looking at today something very special. This laptop is very cool. Part of the Creator Exchange event. This is just launched today, this laptop. We're going to unbox it, have a look. It's actually very interesting because it's more the size and the weight of an Ultrabook, but it's actually a 15-inch laptop, and it's aimed at creators that want a laptop that's sort of Ultrabook sort of weight, but also has a 15-inch display. So this is the 15-inch Ultrabook sort of weight, and it's going to blow the doors of pretty much every Ultrabook because we do have discrete GPU and we have a 35-watt Intel, yes, Intel CPU. So let's have a look. So yeah, nah, even though this is a 15-inch creator laptop, it should not be compared to, say, the X1 Carbon, MacBook Pro 14, 16, and XPS 15, because they are in a completely different price point. And they are much bigger and heavier than this thing, okay? This is ultra portable. And I can't wait to have a look at the OLED on this because it's supposed to be really good. So, let's open her up, unbox, have a look. First thing we get is a bag. Wolf, how cool is that? I mean, come on. A lot of laptop vendors should be doing this, but this is awesome that you get this bag. We'll have a look at this bag later in the review. In the box, we have another box. And ASUS are in the search of incredible. Have they found it here? Nice eco packaging there. There you go. There, the VivoBook Plus environment. Yes, eco packaging. That's what we want to see these days. Oh, yes, it is much lighter than the MacBook Pro 16. I can give it a tip. That is very, very light. Does it have one of those signature finishes there? You can see there, signed VivoBook. So it's this nice sort of bluish sort of color, bluish gray sort of color. What are they saying there? They're saying the best ASUS OLED for creators. Yes, 100% P3. Yes, that's what we want. And also 70% less blue light. That's what you get with OLED. You also get quick response, the beautiful blacks. Panto certified. It's got a CPU and GPU, so you're going to get the performance there. And it is an NVIDIA Studio laptop. So I'm liking it so far. I just want to see what sort of power brick this has. That's what you get. Look at it. 120 watts, tiny little power brick. This thing is really portable, so it's like an Ultrabook sort of weight there. 1.65 kilos, just over 3 pounds, so that is Ultrabook sort of weight there. And there's going to be no compromise, right? You get an OLED display, you get a 15-inch display instead of a 13 or 14 inch, and you get a GPU, which you don't get with Ultrabooks, right? You might not be able to see there, but it does have a privacy shutter on that webcam, so that's pretty cool. Windows 11. It comes with Windows 11 out of the box. Now, this is the first laptop I've had that comes with Windows 11 out of the box. So, woof. Let's rattle off the specs here. The one I have here is the i7-11370H. It's a quad-core, 8 threads. You can also get the i5-11300H. The GPU options are a GTX 1650 and an RTX 3050. So this should be compared to Ultrabooks. It's going to blow away Ultrabooks. You just know that right now. How's this OLED display looking? It's looking good to me. Oh my God, look at that pop of that screen. Oh, that is just delicious, isn't it? That pop, it is so good. A little bit glossy, but the pop is just amazing. That's what you get with OLED, the black, the vibrant colors, the contrast, the crispness. You can't beat OLED for that, especially the crispness. Gotta say, I'm very impressed. 1080p display, 15.6 inch, 100% P3. So it is a top tier display there. And I think at 100%, 1080p is not too bad. Would like to have seen it maybe have been a higher resolution, but I've got to say, it just looks really nice, that display. It is awesome. Now, it says it can do up to 45 watts on the CPU, even though this is a 35-watt CPU and we have a 55-watt RTX 3050. So you can see here, even though this weighs pretty much what an Ultrabook weighs, it's going to blow away all the Ultrabooks, especially the ones without GPU. And let's face it, Ultrabooks don't really have GPU, so this is just going to blow them away. And this is for the creator that wants something ultra portable. Have a look at that enter key there. It does have like a texture on that key as well. Very light. That's the first thing I notice. We have lots of ports on it. We have load of USB type A's, 3 to be exact. We have HDMI 1.4, which is, you know, just if you want to connect it to a projector, you can do it. 1.4 is perfectly fine for that sort of thing. A big trackpad, it is a big, nice trackpad. I've got to say, it feels pretty good. Thunderbolt 4 and this little tiny 120 watt brick, as I showed you before. But one thing here is it is a barrel charger, of course, because it's over 100 watts. So this is something very unique, a 63 watt hour battery. So with this 35 watt part in here, you should get some decent battery life out of that. And that's how you keep the weight down, all right? If you've got the 45 watt part, you're probably going to have an 80 watt hour battery, or, you know, 90 or 100 watt hours. This can go to 65 watt hours because it has the low powered CPU and has Xe graphics as well. It's 11th gen, all the good stuff you get with that at great price point. And my first impressions are, wow, the screen, I like that. I like the weight of it. You know, when I'm picking up these other laptops, like even the MacBook Pro 16, that's really heavy for what it is. Even the XPS 15 is heavy compared to this, and even the X1, anything in that sort of category is much heavier than this. This is definitely Ultrabook sort of weight there. So very unique. I like the OLED display. Now, I will put up some benchmarks they've done with this on the screen. Of course, I'm going to test this stuff out for myself, and you can see, you can compare it to the M1, right? You want to be comparing this to Ultrabooks, M1, stuff like that. Not MacBook Pro 16s, not XPS 15s, anything with 45 watt parts. This is genuinely Ultrabook, okay? And for creative work, we'll see how this performs. I think it will perform pretty good. It's going to perform a hell of a lot better than an Ultrabook with no GPU. So yeah, stay tuned for my full review on this.